When we develop Laravel web application for corporate clients and they need to deploy to a cloud hosting solution, some clients need to keep consistency and will be forced to follow corporate governance and pick platform for you. On the agency side, if you had the choice, would you choose AWS or Microsoft Azure? We went through just that for a client recently, and in this video, I will share with you the results of our review and the comparison of which hosting platform makes more sense to host your corporate Laravel web application. Let's get to it. Hey, my name is Sylvain Reiter, and on this channel, we explore the best practices to deliver better websites, software as a service, and web application by focusing on user-centered technology. I'm here to share my 15-year experience of co-running an agency that will help you make better decisions on your next digital project. So, as we saw in a recent video up there, Laravel is widely used in the enterprise these days. As a long list was published on a Twitter thread recently by Taylor Otwell, creator of Laravel. You can see here the names like Pfizer, Warner Bros., MasterCard, many others. And that's normal. It's one of the best open source framework for developers, and it comes with a lot of the tools to automate the testing and the deployment. We've been using it for years and gain experience in deploying application on both AWS and Azure cloud platforms. Never got the chance to try GCP, so let me know in the comments below if you did it. So as I was saying, a few weeks ago, a new client asked us to take over their platform from their previous agency and ask us to migrate the Laravel web application away from dedicated servers. Yeah, I know it's almost 2022, but it's still happening. And they asked us like which platform was best. So we had to compare both platforms to try and convince their IT department. And we looked at several criteria, looking at the setup time, the service compatibility, the compliance, the ongoing maintenance, and overall cost. So let's compare those platforms and rate them one by one. Starting with the setup time, you can deploy with infrastructure as code on both platforms, and that's best practices, we all know that. To reduce management time though, platform as a service offering makes a lot of sense for most use cases and the most common apps. In our experience, the AWS platform as a service is much more mature and all the services work well together, can be set up in a matter of hours. With Azure, however, you cannot automate all of it. There are some additional manual steps that you want to make advanced network security settings, which will take several days. So on the setup time, it's 1-0 to AWS. Second point on compatibility with the Laravel application. When you run a large Laravel install at scale, it uses a lot of different services from queues and service workers, cache and configuration management, and many others. Now, having deployed projects on both infrastructures, we found that Microsoft is not as reliable on those advanced services. Probably because historically AWS has had a better approach and more compatible with open source technology, so it's a better place to run your Laravel application. You can even plug services like Laravel Forge on top of AWS to take care of everything. So on compatibility, it's 2-0 for AWS. Third, on the compliance. Obviously, Microsoft has a bigger footprint in the corporate world, usually predating the cloud where most organizations used to run Windows and Exchange mailboxes, those type of things. So Microsoft might have a slight advantage, but there's no point comparing the number of industry standards or compliance certification for each, because they're both running and hosting government website and mission critical services for medical or defense application. Let's call it a tie here. It's 3-1. Looking at maintenance post-launch, I've mentioned that for most use cases, the platform as a service minimizes maintenance, but the Azure solution is just not as robust. It seems to require much more time to maintain and tweak and upgrade. We've even seen the Azure team introducing changes to a production environment for queue workers without any warning. On AWS, it seems that everything just works out of the box for like Redis, Elasticsearch. You don't need any extra config, it just connects and works. So on the maintenance side, AWS wins again, and we're at 4-1. Finally, on the cost, comparing likes for likes with an enterprise setup with extra redundancy, multi-availability zone, and strict network security policies, the public pricing on Azure, it's almost 3 times the price as AWS. but I know that most corporate organizations would have very good discount with Microsoft. But the overall pricing on Azure gets just quite complicated between the different database licenses and the multiple tiers of services when you start expanding across region. Again, there's a slight advantage for AWS here, and it's getting to 5-1 in my score. So that's it, looking at the overall AWS wins. From our experience of managing dozens of projects, it is the best platform to run such application. As I said earlier, I've not had the chance to experience GCP, and I've dabbled a bit with smaller provider and the digital oceans for some R&D projects, but let me know in the comments below if you had success with running corporate projects on some of those other platforms. If you need help with enterprise cloud hosting solution, feel free to reach out. While you're at it, go ahead and watch this video to make sure you own your cloud hosting account. And if you need to scale, check this video. It's all about scaling your hosting solution in the cloud. Until next time, stay safe and see you soon.